three blue holes in the darkness to see the great light. And those living in a land of deep darkness are like the dawn. You have enlarged the nation and increased their joy. They rejoice before you as people rejoice at the harvest, as warriors rejoice. When dividing the plunder, for as in the day of Midian's defeat, you have sharpened and yoked the burdens of the power across their shoulders, the rod of their oppressor. Every warrior's boot is used in battle, and every garment worn in blood will be destined for burning, will be fuel for the fire. For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders. And he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace.
Thank you. September 1939, it was not uncommon to hear it be over by Christmas. Just as people had said at the start of World War I, 25 years earlier. Unknown to the people of Britain in 1939, there would be five more Christmases before the fighting, once again, draws to a close. Many of the first Christmases of World War II were similar to the previous Christmases of the charge in 1930s. However, the blackout meant that Christmas trees in towns and villages were not lit up. Shopping window displays were unlit, and decorations in houses could not be seen from the road outside. Petrol rationing had been introduced in September 1939, and rail travel was discouraged. The travelling to visit family was very difficult. Food had not yet been rationed, but that was all to change in the new year, and butter and bacon were the first groceries to be rationed. With the onset of rationing, the next month, many families were determined to enjoy the first Christmas of the war, but they still could. But for many families, Christmas would never be the same again. Many men were somewhere in France, part of the British Expeditionary Force, and many city children had been evacuated from their homes and sent to live in a new country. Many local communities raised money for the evacuated children to have Christmas parties. Christmas presents began to reflect the war. Many children were given targets of blackout and evacuation. And in a short area after, the Navy uniforms were quite popular. Carol singing and pantomimes continued to be very popular, and a Christmas speech on the radio by the King, George VI, was so well received that a Christmas message from the monarch, continued to be broadcast still. As the war progressed, celebrating Christmas in a traditional way became a lot of a challenge. The people in Wales continued to mark it in as an important family occasion, even welcoming evacuee children into their homes. Peter Harmon from London recalled being evacuated to Burry Port. He considered himself to be a handful as a child, but returned to Burry Port after the war, and as an adult to visit the people who had shown him such kindness. As we prepare to celebrate Christmas, we would like you to reflect on how the people in Wales felt 8 years ago, and to think about the people around the world who are still living in areas of conflict.
Oh. Now Thank you.